Welcome to the team. Welcome to the cloud session. This session will be useful for those who are learning in IT and those who are already working in IT. This session will be very useful for them. So this is the agenda, today's agenda. What is cloud computing? Why cloud computing? The principles of cloud computing, characteristics of cloud computing, benefits of using cloud, cloud services model, and top cloud providers, and what are the services available in AWS. Now, let's start with what is cloud computing. So cloud computing is an enterprise business model for enabling on-demand network access. This is very, very important, on-demand network access. On-demand network access to share a shared resource pool of configurable computing resources such as networks, servers, storage, services, and applications. I think those who are in IT, you might hear this word, on-demand network services, servers, storage, services, and applications. So we'll see in detail all these points. This is the topics we are going to cover. The details, the full details you will see later. This is used to reduce the user effort, minimal user effort and minimal management of the provider interactions. So a cloud computing model is composed of following five essential characteristics. First one is on-demand self-services. I think everyone knows what is on-demand self-services, which means the server time, the network, the storage, the email, and without human interaction, the service will be provided automatically, which means that a lot of automation process will be done. So this is called on-demand self-services. A broad network access. Then resource pooling. So resource pooling is like multi-tenant model. It's irrespective of the location and dependency. So next is rapid elasticity and measured services. And continuation with in this slide, we see the five essential characters. Here, that's the characteristics. These are the cloud computing service models. There are three models. One is software as a service. Next is platform as a service. Third is infrastructure as a service. Again, there are four computing deployment models. One is a private. Second one is a community, third one is a public, and fourth one is a hybrid model. So we all these characteristics and the service models and the deployment models we'll see in detail the further slides. The cloud computing allows users to access the same kind of applications in online. This means the device accessing the cloud does not go to work as hard. By hosting software platforms and databases remotely, the cloud servers really serve the memory and computing power of the individual computers. By cloud computing, what is the benefits we are getting? Pay as you use. These are the benefits. 24/7 support. Device and location independent. Easy and agile development. Utility based. Highly automated. Free ups the internal resources. Secure storage management, reliability, scalability, and sustainability. These are the features we have. In the previous slide, we made seen there are five essential characteristics of cloud computing. So here, on-demand services, broad network access, rapid elasticity, and measured services, and resource pooling. These are the service model, software as a services, platform services, infrastructure services, and these are the deployment models in cloud computing. Public cloud, private cloud, hybrid cloud, and community cloud. Next slide, you will see the first topic of essential characteristics of cloud computing. First one is on-demand self-services. What is on-demand self-services? A consumer or end user can perform most of the activities by themselves with minimum human interactions. Say an example of the web portal. The portal, all the portals and command line tools and SDKs and REST APIs, these are all all on-demand services. The REST API, say an example is the Google Map REST API, some software SDKs, online command line tools. These are all some sample examples for on-demand self-services. Next is broad network access. Any cloud services will be available over the network and accessed through the standard mechanism, example like mobile phones, tablets, laptops, and workstations. Finally, the resource pooling. The resource pooling is the ability to use pool of resources to serve a multi-tenant model. Resources can be assigned dynamically and resale according to the consumer demand. Next is rapid elasticity. Rapid elasticity is a quickly scaled up services to scale the resources or recover. Users can use provisioning resources to pay for allocation time period. Yeah, this is very important, the pay for the allocation time period. So in the cloud, the provisioning services what we will be using, we can pay for the allocation of time and period based on that. Example, application workload, predicted workload, experienced workload. So if any peak hours coming, we can, based on that, we can increase the load. If it is not a peak hour, we can reduce the load. So this will save the cost for the company or any other individual users. So avoid the cost of ideal computing resources. The system is not used, the application is not used, and we can shut down, and there is no shutdown or there is no cost for the ideal computing resources. Second is on-demand changes. Third is auto-scaling. So automatically add or remove the resources and the monitoring resources. So we can do the monitoring as well, how many users our system is working, whether it's scaling automatically or not. So all the monitoring metrics the AWS is provides. Mesh services. Renting a cloud service for a particular time period, it's very, very one of the important one. So rent a cloud service for the particular time period. Example, we can rent for storage. So any 10th result is coming, we can rent for this particular the April and May month only. So this is one of the example. So any festival is coming, we can rent more services. So the remaining time, we won't want anything. So in this case, we do not want to invest more. So we can use the renting services. So what and all we can rent? Storage, processing, bandwidth, and active user accounts. Resource usage can be tracked and controlled and reported, providing transparency for both provider and consumer. So provider is a cloud provider, Amazon, Google, AWS, Azure. These are the providers, and consumers, we are the users of the utility services. These are the benefits we are getting. Pay as you go, the CPU usage, how much your CPU is used in the peak hours or normal hours, based on the location, so and region, and the storage type, and support. So based on this category, you will pay the cost. And technology revolution. So any latest technology and application, you can use that. And reshaping the old business models and develop and run applications and consume services. Next is benefits of cloud computing. So the economic benefits of the change from CapEx to OpEx, not to procure and provision for services, servers, stronger and better security in the cloud. These are the key points. So in the earlier slide, we have seen all the characteristic services of the cloud computing. There are 5 characteristic services. We have seen this in the previous slide. Now we are moving to the next section, the cloud service models. There are 3 types of cloud services model. One is software as a services. Second is platform as a services. Third is infrastructure as a services. So here, if you see the diagram, so in the before cloud, how that the system is maintained. So all these items owned by the customers. So in the customer owned all these items like IaaS, applications, data, runtime, middleware, OS, virtualization servers, storage, and network. Everything managed by the customers. But after cloud, so the services are classified in this category, IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. So in IaaS, we see what is applications. Applications, things we install and use. Whatever the application we need, that application we will install and use in cloud. So data means any database. And runtime, it's a runtime for the cloud. Either it could be a Java runtime or it could be .NET runtime. So middleware is sending messaging systems to sending SMS, queues, all these messages, notification, all these systems are middleware. Then OS is an operating system. It could be a Windows or Linux, anything, any OS. Then virtualization, it's a virtualization layer. And VMware sits on top of these virtualizations. Then servers, then networking. So networking is routing the data. So all these items managed by the customer. So before cloud. So now after cloud, the model is classified in these three categories. The highlighted green is delivered to the customer. Highlighted green is delivered from the providers. And the one is yellow, white is delivered from the customer. So if you are onboarding to the cloud, you have to analyze. The cost will be deducted based on these models. So how we are using, say you won't buy your virtualization servers, storage, network, but application you have to install. So if you are providing an IaaS, if you are taking the model as an IaaS, you have to own for installing your applications and managing your database and runtime, everything. But if you are go for PaaS model, the providers and customers, you have to own the highlighted green one, runtime, middleware, OS, virtualization server, storage, and networking. And the applications and data owned by us. So the application, whatever we are developing, we can install and we can choose our own database. And just everything owned by the providers. Software as a service, software deployed. These are the items we have seen. In the diagram, we will be seeing the details section. So software deployed as a hosted services in the cloud and accessed over the internet. This is operated by the third-party provider, example, Office 365, Gmail, and Salesforce. And also the entire stack is managed by the provider. The entire stack, not from the customers. It is platform as a service. It provides a fully managed platform environment for developers to build applications quicker. We can use the languages, either Java or .NET and other apps. So customer is responsible for their specific applications. The third one is infrastructure services. Provides compute, power, and storage services on demand over the internet. The customer is responsible to configure and manage each virtual resources. And these are the top cloud providers. So Amazon, Microsoft, Amazon provides AWS web services, and Microsoft is Azure, and Google is Google Cloud Platform, and IBM Cloud, and many more, but these are the top cloud providers. Here, these are the providers, but we are going to see some brief introduction about AWS alone. So Amazon Web Services. So what is AWS? AWS is Amazon Web Services, it's a cloud provider. AWS provides servers and services that we can use on demand and scale easily and cost effectively. AWS powers the website of top companies in the world. Say an example of Amazon.com and Netflix. This is the AWS services. If you log in and see, so these are the AWS services. AWS offers various services. And Google also, we have a similar services, and Microsoft Azure also have a similar services. So these are the services we can use for EC2 container. So this is the title to compute, storage, database, and migration and transfer, networking, content delivery, and some of the developer tools, robotics. It's a customer enablement, satellite, management and governance. So management governance means the cloud watch, these are the top services. Whatever we install in the AWS cloud, the cloud watch is a monitoring tool. It will monitor our services and share the report. So any load or downtime, so everything will be CPU usage, everything will be captured and monitored, and the cloud watch service will share the report. And auto scaling, these are the top services. Currently, it's running in the most of the services used in the industry. Cloud formation, auto scaling, cloud trial, and media services. So I'm going to highlight some of the top services. Just see here. Machine learning. So now machine learning, these are the services available for machine learning. Those who want to learn anything specific, you can here we can go for machine learning services and management services in compute and storage. There are different category. We can learn the top AWS services to improve our skills. And the cost and management, this is whatever we are going to use in AWS. So for cost savings, it also provides tools to see how the cost is coming for our services and budget, all those stuff. So we can see using AWS cost management. And customer engagement, business applications, and IoT. So these are the popular containers in AWS. So mainly hugely used set of services in the AWS containers. So we used to say ECR, ECS, and Kubernetes services. The Kubernetes service is also very important. For Docker container, we'll use the Kubernetes. Lot of switches in Kubernetes services, that's also offers in AWS. These are the AWS services. The same thing available in Azure as well. And we have Google Cloud also offering some of the popular services. I think we have seen all these top services in the AWS. One of the most popular services is S3. S3 allows to storing files in the buckets and directories. S3 means simple storage services. We can store, it's the most cost-saving services in AWS. We can store our video files, our result data, and whatever data will be large, logging files. Whatever data is very huge, very large, those kind of data to store, we can use S3 services. So it's a cheap and cost-effective services. And we can also do the backup and Azure options also available. So name of the bucket should be, how to, these are the features of S3. The how to give the name for the S3 bucket, it should be globally unique. So globally unique means when AWS have multiple regions, we can store the data in different regions. Let me show the regions. So these are the regions available in AWS. If you want to store any data, we can choose this nearest region based on our business availability, we can store the data. This is called regions. So we have the Africa and US and Canada and Middle East, all these places, the server is available. So in this server, in this region, we can store the data. The buckets are defined at the region level. So that is the region I have seen. So whatever data is stored in the bucket is nothing but a directories. So it's based on the region level. So based on the demand, we can store the data in one location. And this is the top positions in AWS. If you learn, if you go to the service, if you see, for any developer you want to learn in cloud, you can go and you must learn this containers, the containers, elastic container, less container service, elastic Kubernetes services and registry. Along with that, we have Lambda and EC2 and storage and database. So these are the services any developer can learn and improve their existing skills as well as learn new skills. and VPC and CloudFront and route. There is one important is the API gateway. So, and that anyone want to do perform a system administrator and network thing, they can use this network and content delivery services. They get use and LAN. And these are the services we'll be using for security and identity and compliance. The firewall services is there, and auditing managers is there, and inspector is there, and IAM is there. IAM is nothing but to create users and roles and provide permission to view your services. So if anyone want to access our services, we will be creating users and groups and roles and policies. So based on that, we can provide a access. If you are administrator, you will have a separate group. If you are a student, you can have a separate group. If you are an employer, you can have a separate roles. And also we can set how to access all these settings we can do by using these IAM services. So any AWS, if you learn any of the positions, so the IAM is very, very important. So this is part of security. So I think everyone knows the groups, the various groups we can create, whether we can create a group for admin, super admin, users, client. Based on that, we can create and users and roles as well. Other thing is security. If you go for services, what are the other important services like in security? The resource access manager, how we can access our resources and directory services,